زكريا إذ نادى ربه نداء خفيا قال رب إني وهن العظم مني واشتعل الرأس شيبا ولم أكن بدعائك رب شقيا.
حكومة تكيل بخلو محمد الدين.
As a matter of fact, recently there is a rabbi, chief rabbi in Israel, mm-hmm. who have studied Islam.
Yes.
And now he went back to the original scripts of the Torah.
Yes.
And he found out that indeed Muhammad is the last and the seal of the prophets. And he's the one who's going to come at the end. As a matter of fact, there is, if you Google somewhere on the internet, you find out many of the Jews, when you go to the Wailing Wall, they say, Muhammad, 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 Muhammad.
You have no right to translate names of people. But they have been doing that. Muhammad Im, they translated as altogether lovely. But the word Muhammad is there in the Hebrew language in the original.
In reading the English translation of Song of Songs 5:16, it finishes the description by saying, he is altogether lovely, but what most people don't know is that the name of that man was given in the original Megillat. Here is verse 16, and how it is written in ancient Hebrew, before introducing the vowels, in the 8th century. From the Hebrew Bible, on scripturetext.com. Here is the word in question. This word is made of four letters.
Mem. Het. Mem. Dalet.
Now when reading the word as it is written in its original form, with no vowels, it can be read as Muhammad, which is the name of the Muslim prophet, or as Mamad with no A after the H. According to Ben Yehuda's Hebrew-English Dictionary, it is correctly pronounced as Muhammad, not Mamad. So how we're going to know for sure if it's pronounced as Muhammad, the Muslim prophet, or as Mamad, a random Hebrew word, the only way is to give the verse to a rabbi and say to him, please read. Here is the Song of Songs 5:16, and how it is read by a rabbi from a Hebrew-Jewish site. Please notice, the im in Hebrew is a plural of respect.
Hikoman takim vechullo Muhammadin ze dodi vezer'i benot Yerushalayim. Hikoman takim vechullo Muhammad 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 Muhammadin.
Muhammad, Muhammad.
Why would they be saying that?
Because it is in their script and they know it without knowing what they're talking about.
Uh-huh.
But he became a Muslim and he exposed the corruption that happened to the Torah. You see, the people do not realize that God have created us in the most wonderful way, that we can use our brain to think. And if we think properly, we're going to be led to the truth.
Properly, yeah.
And anyone who's really honest to themselves and want to find out the truth, they will find the truth, and the truth will be that Muhammad, peace be upon him, was the last and the seal of the prophets, and Islam is the way of life, and God have made it responsibility on him to protect that Quran from being altered or corrupted. And the fact is, there is millions, if not hundreds of millions, of Muslims who memorize the Quran from the beginning to the end, not only memorize it as words, but they memorize it the way that Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, uttered 1400 years ago.
Yeah.
That by itself convinced all the world that there is only one Quran, and it's not only one Quran, written Quran, it is pronounced the same way as it has been pronounced by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the companions at that time 1400 years ago. So really and truly, if you want the best, look in Islam.
So I, as a rabbi, view Muhammad as one of the greatest prophets to the Gentiles.
Et regardez, chose assez remarquable, le seul peuple au monde, la seule ethnie au monde, qui sert le même Dieu que nous, le Dieu d'Abraham, Dieu unique, éternel, n'ayant ni femme, ni fils, ni petit-fils, ni Saint-Esprit, éternel, sans image, sans représentation, le seul peuple au monde, c'est Ishmaël, l'islam. Tous les autres ont une représentation, ou pas de Dieu du tout, ou plusieurs. Le seul qui sert le même Dieu que nous, le Dieu unique sans forme, elle, c'est eux. Donc dans leur essence, ils ont quelque chose.
And according to the school of thought of Rabbi Benamozeg, this fundamental faith is also called by the name Islam. Some have suggested that this refers to the great number of non-Jewish believers who came to sacrifice the Qurban Shlamim in Jerusalem together with the Jews. Salamai, Muslimai, Muslimi. This could be a clear indication in our literature that Islam is an ancient religion dating back to the time of the Second Temple, or even earlier. And if Islam's roots, if the roots of Islam are the same as what we call B'nai Noach, then for us, it is much older. This is the religion of Noah. This is the religion of Adam himself. The closeness of Islam and Judaism has always been understood by biblical scholars until recent years. The close relationship with the Jews, the ten lost tribes, the Arabs, the Rahabites, all this was assumed to be true. It was only with the advent of German revisionists like Wellhausen and Buchler and others that this began to change. They introduced ideas that Islam had something to do with worshipping the moon, rocks, or some asteroid that fell. But devout Jews know that this is not true. It's a fact of Jewish law that we believe that Muslims and Muslims are perfect monotheists. They worship the same God that we do.
Ислам, кроме всего прочего, он был так сформирован, что те, кто пошли за Мухаммадом, и те, кто в дальнейшем, так сказать, вот, следовали за этой религией, они, как это сказать, они постоянно находились в состоянии общения с Творцом. То есть христианин, ну, он там, если ходит раз в неделю, в воскресенье, в церковь, ну, это хорошо, в чем тоже, так сказать, да. А мусульманин, он 5 раз в день опускается на колени. 5 раз в день. Причем строго выверены по времени, так сказать, я же с ними там живу, да. И кроме того, я когда, вот, скажем, ездил в Европу, я где-то в Риме там в аэропорту был, там такой тихий закуточек, ну, пришло время молиться, значит, я пошел в этот закуточек. Ко мне пришли туда 2 мусульман. Я стоял, молился там свое, они, значит, положили газетки, стали на колени. Это ислам. И, в общем, это говорится о очень много. Человек 5 раз в день, хотя бы на 5, это там молитва очень небольшая. Я смотрел, вот, мне так, была возможность посмотреть молитву, что в ней написано. Значит, молитва очень небольшая, но она очень серьезная, она очень глубокая. Человек на 5 минут становится на колени, наклоняется, произносит то, что там написано, он общается в этот момент со Всевышним. Это очень важно, это очень много. Поэтому ислам, в общем, это религия будущего. Ну, так скажем, вот, если сегодня... И действительно, люди, большинство людей в мире начнет исповедовать ислам. Сегодня уже этот процесс виден, потому что они, так сказать, заполняют, распространяются. И там, я уж сейчас не помню, где-то в одной из европейских стран там категорически запретили строить новые мечети. Да. Но, потому что идет распространение. Будущее мира за исламом. Да, Швейцария, совершенно верно. Будущее мира за исламом, это совершенно точно. Если удастся вот сегодня локализовать ту проблему, которая имеется.
فهب لي